I'm your host, Ted Perch, and today we are in one of my favorite places in the world generally, but we are at the New England School of Architectural Woodworking, and we're speaking with the owner, Greg Larson, about the school. It's located here in East Hampton on Cottage Street. So, Greg, thanks for coming on the show. And so tell us about how the school got here. It's magnificent space, first of all.
It really is. It's been here for, in one form or another, for over 20 years.
Really?
So I'm originally started by Michael Cohen, who's quite a prominent furniture maker in the area, in kind of a more of a furniture-oriented format. And about 1996, I think it was, it started in the current incarnation, the Career Training Academy, which is what the primary focus of the school is. And we took over about 6-7 years ago in 2008. This was a career change for me. I was woodworking since I was a little kid, but took a detour, went to college and engineering school, and made a career in high-tech engineering, but always wanted to get back into this. So when I met my wife, Margaret, in 1999, we started looking for a place for me to go to woodworking school. Mm-hmm. So we, Margaret actually found this school here in Massachusetts. We were living in California at the time. And we moved out here in 2001, and I went to school here and learned a little bit more about, you know, the sort of the art of cabinet making.
Right.
And we ended up having a baby, moving back to California, where I started my own business on the side, and we kept realizing that we loved it out here. So we made plans and moved back here in 2006, I guess it was, and school came up for sale.
That's it.
Decided to make the plunge.
And here you are.
And here I am.
Well, this is a unique kind of school, because I don't know of any, especially anywhere in the area or New England. And when I first saw it on your website, I thought, when I first moved here 2 years ago, I was looking around, I saw it on the website, I thought, oh my God, there's a woodworking school here.
Well,
how cool is that?
There's actually a lot of woodworking schools in New England, but they're all oriented towards furniture making. And we're one of the, really a handful in the country that's oriented towards career training for cabinet makers.
Right.
And there's probably less than six in the country that do this, and we're certainly the only ones on the Eastern Seaboard.
No kidding.
And we're the only ones who do this format. The students actually build custom kitchens for people.
And we're surrounded.
Custom
kitchens in process.
Right.
All sorts of cabinets and uppers and lowers and lazy susans, and it's everywhere. It's beautiful.
It's really neat, because not only do the students get a real world kind of format, you know, of experience. But you know, it's great for the community too, because they're getting probably the best deal in kitchens that there is, because this is a full custom kitchen, fully installed, for probably half the price that you would normally pay.
Yeah.
And it gives, it's kind of like the barber school concept, you know, you get cheap haircuts, and they get great product, and the students, we couldn't do this kind of work if the students had to pay for materials.
Right. Now, your students come from all backgrounds and all ages?
Our average age every year is about 32.
Uh-huh.
So we get a lot of career changers. We get some people who are right out of high school, but probably the bulk of them are in maybe their late 20s to even into the 40s.
Yeah.
So it's very much a career changing kind of orientation for most of them.
Sure.
And we take about 8 to 10 students each year. So it runs January through June on full day.
Right.
So it's about $800.
So now you're in like your second session for the year.
Well, we only run one session.
Oh, January through June.
January through June.
And this is March, so so you're into it.
We're about halfway through. So very, very soon they're going to be finished with these kitchens here.
Yeah.
And we're going to install them probably in late April.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're going to work on personal projects and go out in the world and try to find a job.
So is the kitchen work steady work?
It is now, the word's in and around.
Yeah.
So we only do a couple of these a year. So we're working on, there's one over there and there's one here.
Yeah.
So it's two groups of four this year working on it. And the word's gotten around, and I've already got four or five who want to be on the list for next year. So.
So this is all CAD designed, or is it, you know, it's got to be pretty precise and.
Yeah, I draw it up and do kind of the initial design, and the students help with the sort of the final design. But we do have an AutoCAD class that we offer, so some of the students would like to do the
design work.
Right.
And I'm a guy who turns perfectly good lumber into wood chips and sawdust in my garage, and not my career, but I spent a lot of time in construction and building some of my own cabinets in my own home. But as you come in here, there's some magnificent tools. The power tools are just gorgeous. Anybody who has anything to do with woodworking, man or woman, will just be drooling and falling over themselves because it's paradise. If you're a tool head, it's just paradise.
We've been lucky. I mean, the previous owners did a pretty good job of keeping up with the tools.
Yeah.
We've been lucky enough to be able to add quite a few new tools. We've got the soft stop, which is the one that if you touch it with your finger, it automatically stops.
Yeah, I told you the story about my thumb and in my barn. I cut my finger twice, and then the saw stop came out, and I said, well, it's a little too late for me, but
right.
I still have my thumb. It still works.
Yeah, we all have stories on that.
Yeah.
But yeah, we've got a great set of tools. Very much set up like a real cabinet shop.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, it's a great space, and wood floors are really nice on the feet.
It's beautiful.
Yes, it's been nice, and we've we've gotten a great reputation now around
Wayland
in terms of employers.
Mm-hmm.
And they actually call us and come to us now, asking for employees. So we've been very successful.
Wonderful.
In placing most of the people who come in here.
So you say this is a career. So the people who take the course is it
yeah,
a course?
Yeah.
They're certified, or you get some sort of a
well, we
diploma or something.
Yeah, we're licensed by the state of Mass,
right.
And they get a certificate from us, and they also can elect to, there's a brand new certification being developed for the woodworking industry that I've been working on for the last 4 years.
Yeah.
I'm on the board of directors for that. And so they can elect to do that now as well and graduate with a green certification for the woodworking industry. So, you know, the most important thing is that they've learned the skills they need to work in a cabinet shop, and the employers around here know that, and they come looking to us.
And it's very intricate, and it's very, the tools that you're using are, you know, table saws, and the joinery is all very precise, and it takes a while to learn all that.
Yeah, it's fascinating. People sometimes come in thinking that this is going to be a lot easier than it is, and find out that it's quite difficult to create. It's deceptively difficult to create work of this level.
Well, the design level is very, very high, and I guess you would call it high end. But just the design factors, the proportions are such, and everything is just so beautiful. That's the only word I can use for it.
But, you know, it isn't furniture, but it really is. It is furniture level on cabinets and
right.
You know, while we don't emphasize furniture in our main program, it's the same level of precision. You build furniture if you have these skills. It's just
and particularly you get into making some of the doors and the panels, that's where veneer and inlays and all sorts of things can happen.
Right.
That's the art of it. I mean, this is the art too. I mean, you have to have a good solid base.
Right.
But when you get into the doors and the panels, then, you know, people get.
Yeah, for example, this one over here that I might not be able to see.
You can't see it.
It's a peninsula, and then the end of it is going to, we decided to put a curve on it, so we're bending some wood around for that, and we're going to have walnut burl veneer going around with a hidden door with a touch hatch. So there's lots of fun stuff.
Very tasty. Yes.
Yeah.
Very tasty. Now, the other part of your operation here is that you have what we call the Workbench Woodworking and Craft School. Now, how did that come about?
Well,
which is a separate operation from the school.
Yeah, you're right. We split that off for our night and weekend classes. When we first took over, they had been utilizing the shop because the shop isn't used on night and weekends. So
right.
They had been running a small amount of night and weekend classes. And when we took over, we put a lot of effort in really expanding the amount of night and weekend classes that we do. I'd say we probably added, over the past 4 or 5 years, we probably added 25 new client weekend classes.
Yeah.
And it's become really, it's really starting to take off. Just probably in the past couple of years, I'd say we're getting a lot more people rolling through it. Yeah. We've got over 900 and some people on the mailing list at this point.
Wow.
And
that's amazing.
Yeah.
But then again, woodworking appeals to people. There's something about the material. And when I walked into this your shop here, you know, the sawdust smell, the wood smell is in the air, and I just go, this is where I am.
It's fun. Yeah, and you're right. People react to it.
Yeah.
And one of the big things we've just added recently is turning. So we got.
I saw the room back there with the lathe.
And that's been very popular. Yeah. A lot of people are very interested in that.
And spindles and bowls.
Right, and spindles and bowls.
All sorts of things.
Yeah, the bowls become very popular.
Yeah.
And we have an awesome turning teacher. So it's been,
yeah.
He's got quite a popular.
Now, how many student or participants or students do you have in the workbench?
I'd say active people.
Well, they come to go, I suppose.
Yeah, that's the thing. They're short-term classes, more oriented towards the hobbyists. So, you know, we probably have hundreds of people funnel through here. And now we've got a core group who take more and more classes. So tonight, we're here during our open shop, which we instituted last year.
Yeah.
And that's been fun because it's really starting to build up. And we've had people now take our beginning classes and actually start coming in here now on Thursday nights and now some limited Saturdays as well. And they're building their own products. So they've actually learned woodworking from scratch here and are starting to build their own products.
And on a professional knowledge level, rather than just hacking away, you have the tools, you have the instruction,
right. And
the space. The space is just magnificent. I told you before. So, my God, this is just beautiful.
Yeah, people really react to it.
Especially with the tools, you have to spread out.
Right.
You know.
Right. Yeah, we've got almost 5,000 square feet of space scattered about here.
Yeah.
And you know, we've had a lot of. What's nice now is we're starting to put in classes by request. So we had somebody request a mortise and tenon class, and we're starting that next week.
Yeah.
You know, we've got veneering and turning and our basic series of classes as well.
The joinery is so cool. There's so many different variations of joining, and when I see it, you see a piece that's got dovetails or something like that. It's just like, I'd like to make that. You know?
Right. Well, that's for one of our very popular classes is the hand cut joinery. So it's the hand cut dovetails, the mortise and tenons, and so on. And we've got a bending wood class that's coming up.
Unless you have the facility to do that, it's hard to be able to do that on your own.
Right. Yeah. And and that's the other nice thing is even for people who have shops at home.
Yeah.
What we'll find is some of them will come in here and pay for the open shop hours. If you can buy as little as 3 hours and up to 50 hours, and they might fill in with tools that they don't have at home, prep some stuff, and then bring it back home to work on later.
So. It's open to the general public. And on your website, you can apply for the class or whatever it is.
Yeah, all the classes you can sign up for online. The open shop class, we prefer that people at least take one of our basic classes, or can demonstrate that they have the woodworking knowledge necessary to do it. We have a short Saturday class that you can take. It's a milling class.
Yeah.
That if you have some experience, we recommend that people do that. It's just a 3-hour class, and then I can evaluate them and make sure that everything's okay.
That they don't go running off and use a tool. Either hurt themselves or blow the tool out and say, oh, sorry, it broke.
And we have a highly qualified instructor here at all times.
Yeah, that's important too.
Make sure.
You can get stuck working on a project, thinking, what do I do next? And there's a process to constructing things that you can follow.
Right. Because if you're just starting out, you might have some skills, but you need a little hand.
And
make sure you're safe.
Right. Using the table saw, that's very important.
It is.
And sharpening hand tools. Now there's.
That's been a very popular one because we're teaching a very simple, straightforward sharpening system that people can do at home very easily because you can easily screw things up.
I've got plenty of buttered up chisels at home but. To know how to really, sharpen a tool the right way.
Right.
It's a skill that you have to learn.
I mean, how many people have picked up a plane or a chisel from their grandpa's barn or something, and you go on a purchase and you throw it away and say, hand tools or...
Heck, whether I go use a rod or I'll use something else for it.
But a really sharp tool is quite a different world.
So yeah. And it takes practice to be able to use a hand tool.
It does.
Well.
That's why we also have...
hand plane tune.
Hand plane tune up and use.
Yes, and milling rough lumber, spindle turning, using the router, one of the, the universal tool that I have several of them at home, and I use them once in a while because I'm not so active in furniture making or woodworking anymore. But
a lot of people have them sitting around.
And they're sitting around, and it's like, yeah, and they're very versatile.
Right.
Unbelievably so.
Yeah, and what's been great is you might see tonight we've got just a crazy, nice mix of people who are in here, anywhere from younger people to retired people, and it's kind of an equalizer that brings
us together. Well, yeah, it's a great social experience coming in, and everybody's working on something at the same level, and you get to meet people, and it's a great place to come. And they'll recommend it to their, their friends, their buddies. Yeah. Now I see you have kids workshops too.
We started doing some of those the last couple of years. We're working on developing that in a much more formal and bigger program. So right now it's been sort of some after school.
Yeah. Oh, cool. After school.
Yeah, for like 9 to 11 year old
type
age range. But we're hoping to expand that moving forward.
It's a great place for kids to be after school rather than hanging around. Come and go in the woodshop.
Right. Yeah, and learn a useful skill.
And learn a useful skill, something that you'll always have.
Yeah, well, what we're finding is I think just with the general public too is it used to be that you grew up around people using tools all the time. It was your grandfather, your uncle, whoever it might have been.
Right.
And now we're getting whole generations of kids and even adults now who have grown up and not really gotten a chance to use tools.
Yeah, that's right.
So we're getting a lot of people coming in saying that. Never been exposed to this. I don't know how to, and I can't teach it to my kids, so they're looking for a place.
Yeah, and when I was in high school or junior high school, we had shop classes.
Right.
Wood shop, metal shop, whatever, and we learned some of the basics and how to use a hammer, how to use a lathe,
right?
Very basic stuff. But yeah, that's true. And even when do-it-yourself, the homeowner programs, this old house and homes on homes, and some of these programs are wildly popular.
Right.
With just people doing part of the work, and then at the same time you think, well, not many people really know the business end of a hammer and what to do with it.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. And which is why one of our other classes has also been very popular, the trim carpentry class. So that's crown molding, door and window trim, and that sort of thing.
Which can be a killer.
Yes. It can be a killer.
I have thrown away plenty of crown molding because I cut it wrong. It's like, what?
Right. Because you got to do it upside down.
Got it upside down and backwards. And that's hard to know.
It is.
It's hard to learn. I don't know if it's hard to learn, but once you learn, it's like, there's a whole approach to it that's cool.
Especially around New England with all these old houses. There's a lot of people who want
to
do that.
I have molding in my house. You can't people would have to reproduce it because it's not available. I've gone to local lumber yards and said, this is the molding on my house. And they look at it and say, nah,
right.
Not anymore. So this would be possibly a place to come and reproduce it on my own.
We have a molder.
Yeah. For it. Oh, this is great. This is just a wonderful place. So now, I don't want to forget this, and I'm sure you didn't want to either, but you are having an open house. So tell us all about that.
Open house, April 12th from 9 to 2. And what it's primarily for is these kitchens will be mostly done at that point. And it's for our students, our patients to show up, and for their friends and family.
Yeah.
But we also have... We have set up for the workbench as well, so people can come and see the types of projects that we're doing. A brand new class that we have is an Adirondack chair class.
Spring. I saw those over there before,
It's spring, so it's about time to
start making those chairs, get them out there and want.
But anybody's invited, friends and family and prospective students, if you want to check out the place and see what we do.
Oh, good.
We'll be open.
So April 12th, 9 to 2, right?
Yep.
Right here.
Right here.
In Esau, which is at the Cottage Street Studios, one Cottage Street, but you have to come around the back of the building from Union Street, There's a parking lot, and it's way in the back.
Yep.
And there's a lot of construction going on lately because of their renovating part of the building, but...
Yeah, loading dock B when you come home.
Loading dock B.
And we're right there on the first floor.
Right, which is way in the back, so... Actually, it's easy to find once you find it, but it's...
Yeah. If you go on our website under the Contact Us page, there's very detailed instructions.
Right, that's right. Yeah, we're in the building, but you won't be able to find us if you walk in the front door. You have to go up low.
You follow your GPS to the
front door. Follow your GPS.
Yes, you won't get it.
Follow your GPS, because you'll need it. And now you have... Now, this is a cut sheet of the things that at the workbench, woodworking and craft school. All of the workshops, open shop time, the rates for certain hours, and
private lessons.
Less private lessons and so forth.
We offer as well.
And that's on the website. We're going to put this, at least your web address, on the program so people can access it. But you're right downtown. You have to come around the back of the building because that's where the parking lot is, unless you want to wander all over the place. But we'll put that on there. And is there anything else that we forgot?
I think we had a
list of points we wanted to cover.
I think we did.
Good. Well,
I appreciate you coming to show us off.
Thank you. But I mean, this is great. People should get to know that it's here because I think there'll be any of the wood hackers, men or women, who struggle with sometimes building birdhouses or anything else, they should know about this and come in, particularly for the workbench, because this is where you can learn and grow your skill. And accomplish something that's beautiful.
Yeah.
When you have the equipment and you have the space and you have the time, you can concentrate and plenty of elbow room, and you're learning something new, and it's a great experience. It's a lovely place.
Thank you.
Anyways, thanks for tuning in, and this has been another edition of In Studio. Been talking with Greg Larson about the New England School of Architectural Woodworking and the Workbench Woodworking and Craft School. So April 12th, they have an open house, and I hope to see you then. Good night. Infinitely adjustable and stays put.
Yes,
and it's
nice.
Almost makes it easier than it is, but it's easy. Zip, zip.
back.